calling all female ballers. If you want to elevate your game to the next level, if you want to play and be considered one of the GOATs like Lisa Leslie, Cheryl Miller, Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant, basketball IQ is what you need to learn. Stay tuned to this video right here, and I'm going to show you the steps to being one of the greats. Hey everyone, welcome to She Got Game TV. My name is Coach Kim. I'm from For the Love of Basketball. We're here in the Bay Area, and today we're going to discuss probably one of the most important things about basketball, which is basketball IQ. Alright? I think that in girls basketball, it's very important to understand the game of basketball. What it means, what the lines on the court means, what the positions, how you play, offense, defense, and just key things, key words that are used by coaches and by players to just help you understand and get a better flow of the game. So today we're going to talk a little bit about basketball IQ. We're going to break it down to what I call basketball fundamentals 101, the basics, and then we're going to build up from there. So stay tuned. So when we talk about basketball IQ, there's so many different categories to basketball IQ, all right? But for me, I want to break down the basics, all right? I think that when you talk about basketball, you talk about a team sport, you talk about five individuals. And I think it's very important that each individual understands what basketball is, what team basketball is, and understanding the roles that every person on each team plays to put together that five-on-five concept. So in order for you to begin to have what we call team basketball IQ, I think that it's very, very important for each player to have what we call individual basketball IQ. And that's just understanding the general basic, having the general basic knowledge of basketball. And so that's what we're getting ready to break down now. So first thing we're gonna talk about is individual basketball IQ. So I think it is very important that when you first start playing the game of basketball, that you understand everything about the game. The origin of the game, where it started, who created the game of basketball, all right? Then you can start to break down the game, all right? Where, what is a dribble, all right? What is a jab step, all right? What is a chest pass? What is a bounce pass? What is an overhead pass, all right? And then you can begin to talk about shooting. What is a right hand layup? What is a left hand layup? What is a middle layup? What is a power layup, all right? So, once you begin to understand that aspect of basketball, then you can begin to start branching out into the positions on the court. For me, I think that it's very important that, I tell my girls this all the time, that basketball is not just something that, you're going to learn 2 hours with your trainer or, with your coach for practice twice a week. Basketball and beginning to have basketball IQ requires, it's like school. You're going to have to do your homework. You're going to have to go home. You're going to have to read, look things up. I mean, this is a new generation. You know, when I was growing up, we didn't have YouTube and, the internet was just kind of coming around. So, we didn't have, the opportunity that, this generation has to really study and master the game. We kind of had to master the game from, watching games, NBA or, college games and, recording it in our VCR and then playing it back and watching, the game that way and building basketball IQ this way. But now, you have the luxury of sitting in front of your, in your couch and laying down and, really learning the game. So, when we talk about things like, the introduction to basketball and learning how to dribble, there are many things on, many clips and tutorials online that you can use to just kind of master these things. I think that it's very key to master all these skills because it's a buildup, all right? Basketball is not something where you're just gonna walk on the court and just, step back and, side dribble. It doesn't work that way, all right? So it's a buildup. You have to learn, you gotta crawl before you walk. So you have to learn how to dribble, how to pass, how to overhead pass, how to shoot. And, you can learn these things from YouTube and, you know, my tutorials as well, and other tools online to kind of perfect, or maybe not necessarily perfect, but master those skills. And so I tell my kids that is very important, that not only do you put those 2 hours in the gym, but maybe 2 hours after, and maybe 2 hours before, all right? And this is how you begin to have that organic game, because that's what you want to do. The greats, they can just zone out, and they can just let their body do its thing, you know? They can take over. You hear people talk about, oh, you know, Kobe was an amazing player. He just zoned out, and he dropped 34 in the fourth quarter. Or Michael Jordan, you know, he's clutch. He knew that he was going to shoot that jump shot, and you could tell that he wasn't even thinking about it. That's how you master. That's how you become that solid GOAT player, because you have mastered all these small skills, all right? And not only mastering the skill, because it's easy to sit here and put it between your legs, but then understanding, taking that basketball IQ with mastering that skill, putting it together, all right? And knowing when to apply that skill. That is what we talk about when we talk about basketball IQ. So it's taking that skill and then that understanding of the game and putting that together. And that is what equates to being the GOAT. Next thing that I want to go over is what I call team basketball IQ. I think that, you know, once each individual player has kind of built the basic or general understanding of basketball, then you begin to apply that as a team. And I think that's probably one of the hardest things as a coach and as a player to begin to understand that concept, that, like, you know, a lot of players, you know, like to score, and they like to, you know, be, you know, looked at as the Candace Parkers or the, you know, Brittany Griner, where everybody's, you know, they're the go-to player. And so here's where you begin to understand the different roles of basketball, and, you know, knowing when to lead and knowing when to step back and let other people lead. So, you know, this is where I'm gonna really break down, you know, individually how it comes together to become a team basketball IQ, all right? And so one of the most important things for me, especially in girls basketball, is that we are super quiet. We do not communicate on the basketball court. And so in order for you to have basketball IQ, especially team basketball IQ, you're gonna have to learn your teammates. You're gonna have to be able to talk and communicate on the basketball court. And so communication is key to mastering, you know, that team basketball IQ. You know, I have teammates that we were so solid that I know to give a backdoor pass because I know who my teammate is and how they play. And I know that they're able to read, you know, the defender that is defending them. And I know that they know that they can beat them to the basket. And so being able to communicate with my teammates and put that all together is what makes those amazing teams. Because at the end of the day, there's no I in team, all right? It's five players on the court, and it doesn't matter if you have that one superstar, if those other four aren't showing up, you're not gonna win the game. So this is how you build great players and great team basketball, and that's through individual basketball IQ and team basketball IQ. When we talk about team basketball IQ, I think that it's really important to talk about offensive plays, defensive plays, and just really getting your team to each individual to understand the team concept. And I think it's very important to understand how each individual role and how those roles impact the game, all right, if that makes sense. So for me growing up, Chicago Bulls was like one of my favorite teams in the world, and they ran this offense that was called the triangle offense, and I love this offense, and I studied and I've mastered this offense. And not only have I mastered this offense, I have been able to implement this same concept into my press breaks, into my defense, into different styles of offensive plays. So I'm saying all this to say that, you know, for me, I think that it's very important to understand, you know, things like different zones, different man-to-mans, different plays. And so when I teach my girls, you know, team basketball IQ, I definitely break down, you know, the different zones and the different positions and why your teammate plays help side defense to be able to help you if you get beat, and these different concepts, so that they have a better understanding. Because sometimes when you just tell players just to stand here and put your hands out like this, they don't understand why they're doing that. And so when you break it down to them and you break down the other positions as well, I don't just teach one position on the court, I teach all five positions, because it makes it easier for that player to understand why they're moving that way, because it's a unit, all right? And so if one doesn't understand, it disrupts the whole system. And so we want to build that well-grounded understanding of what we're trying to do as a team and what we're trying to accomplish. And that is what Basketball IQ is all about. Making sure that each individual knows every single role on that court, regardless if they're playing that role or not. So they know how to adjust as a team to have the ultimate goal, whether it's a basket or a steal or a defensive stop. So that's what we're working on when we talk about team basketball IQ. This was just an introduction to basketball IQ. This is just the beginning, y'all. Like I said, basketball is an amazing, amazing sport. And if you take the time to really learn and build, you know, watch my tutorials, watch my videos, I guarantee you will learn and appreciate the game of basketball. Definitely more videos on Basketball IQ to come. Y'all come check me out. If you like the video that you saw today, please like, comment, or subscribe to my channel. I appreciate y'all. Have a good one. Peace.